Parents, don't forget to pick up your child's Nuka Sheriff Star after today's Wild West Gun Show
partners. Welcome to Dry Rock Gulch, where it's always high noon. Did you have fun in
Mark Mulligan's mind?
Tussle with any bad outlaws?
That mine was the nest for a bloodworm queen. Now that she's gone, this whole area should be a lot safer.
I can't understand a word of what you're saying, but you've been the best deputy this side of the Mississippi. Here, take some souvenir bottle caps courtesy of the Milka-Cola Janitorial Service Department. You and your friends are welcome in Dry Rock Gulch. Any time.
That's a heavy load.
For a free Milka-Cola file. It's a Bruton. Newton. Good time.
Get up! Thanks for your help, pal.
What did they want?
They were raiders. Anyway. We've got to do something.
Can we trade a few things?
Raider attacks.
Okay.
Let's trade.
Of course.
Anybody need help with anything?
I just want to trade a few things.
Sure thing.
I just want to trade a few things.
Go ahead.
I just need to trade gear with you.
Sure.
Thank you.
Hey.
What's up, Bob?
You're tuned to Radio Freedom, broadcasting across the Commonwealth. Nothing to report. Stay safe, people.
Thank you.
you brought me a new recruit. Thank you, Cleansed. If you've come seeking answers to life's great questions, Hubology has them. While I sincerely hope you'll join us, even if you don't, I'm in need of a person of action.
Hubology? What is that?
Before the Great War, a brilliant writer named Dick Hubble invented a process for expanding the human mind. Through the process of alignment, he was able to give his followers great mental powers. I am his direct descendant and keeper of all his secrets, collectively known as Hubology. If you are really interested in joining us, go speak to Phil about having an alignment. We can help you find inner peace and happiness. We can help you master the amazing powers of the mind.
I'm always for hire, if the price is right.
Good. We need spacesuits, like the one I'm wearing. I'll pay you 200 caps for 5 of them. I've learned that there are some in the galactic zone of Nuka World. I lost 2 followers trying to get them ourselves. I'm hoping you'll have more luck.
What do you need spacesuits for?
I suppose there is no harm in telling you. They will protect us in the battle to come.
I'll need more than that for this job.
Okay, I'll give you 250 caps.
Still not enough.
Driving a hard bargain, I see. Okay, 300 caps.
I think you can afford more than that.
All right, but 350 is my final offer. Now get me those suits.
Hi.
Do you have my spacesuits?
What's that about a spaceship in a junkyard?
It's the reason I need those suits. Without them, we don't have a chance to capture the ship. But enough of that for now. Do you have the spacesuits or not?
What is this Hubology?
Before the Great War, through the process of a... I am his direct...
Uh-huh.
If you are really interested, we can help you find inner peace.
Uh-huh. All 5. Here they are.
Perfect. Here is your payment. We can proceed with the next step in the plan. I'm counting on you to help us with it. We need to take control of the spaceship in the junkyard. I know it's a lot to ask, so I'm willing to give you one of Hubology's great treasures if we succeed.
Why do you want to capture the spaceship?
It is central to Hubology. We are destined to make it fly. More than that, I cannot tell you. It is secret knowledge reserved for AHS 7 members.
You do know it's not a real spaceship, right?
Your mind is limited by neurodynes. If you had my expanded mental powers, you would see the truth about the spaceship.
Together, we can capture that spaceship.
I knew I could count on you. Let's go tell the others.
Everyone gather. Form the wheel.
Hey, boss, can I ask you something?
What's up?
We've been running together for a while now. You ain't afraid to take what you want. And don't let anybody get in your way. Got more guts than most folks. I guess what I'm wondering is, why? What's behind all this for you?
Do I need a reason?
Nope. Suppose not. You ask me, this whole damn world is here just to tear you down. Decks stacked against you from the very beginning. Most folks are too stupid to realize it. They just sort of stumble through, managing to scrape together some shitty little life for themselves. They struggle every day until something catches them off guard, and then that's it. Lights out.
What? You feel bad for them?
Nah. Ain't my fault they're not smart enough to do something different. But then some folks are too aware of it, you know? They see the world for how fucked up it is. And so they decide they're gonna have it all. Right now. All the booze, all the chems, all the caps. And they don't care how they get it. In fact, if they can take it from others, they feel like they're getting the upper hand. Only, they ain't. Fucking raiders. They get so greedy, so focused on right now, they make some shitty mistakes. Wind up dead. Hell, maybe some of them are trying to get killed.
And what about you, Gage? Which type of person are you?
As far as I'm concerned, I ain't either of them. All these people. They either try too hard or not enough. Maybe not at all. You and me, though, we're different. We know how to walk the line between fighting for what we deserve and getting out of control. Don't know about you, but I had this shit figured out early. Grew up in your average crap old settlement with parents that meant well, but they were pushovers. Watched them get smacked around by raider gangs for years, handing over whatever they had to keep their lives. One day, I'm watching them cower in front of some punk with a gun, and it just hits me. I ain't gonna end up like this, I says to myself. So I bail. I'm what, 12 years old? Didn't matter. I'd seen enough of the world to know how shit works.
Where are your parents now?
Who the hell knows? Dead, I'm sure. Probably a long time ago. Doesn't matter. Hasn't mattered in decades. I bounced around for a few years, taking whatever jobs I could to pay for food, one way or another. I was a runner for a caravan for a while. Did some scavenging, did odd jobs for settlements. No matter what, one thing never changed. When the raiders came through, everyone rolled over. Raiders took what they wanted, moved on, and that was that. Didn't take long before I finally figured out where I'd really been heading all along. Next time a gang came through, I joined. Worked my way up over the years, and now here we are. Running with you now? Seems like it was all worth it.
You made the right choice, Gage.
Yeah, I sure did. I'm just saying. It feels like you get it. Whatever you've been through, you can relate. Good to have someone like that around, as far as I'm concerned. Anyway, enough being sentimental, I suppose. Let's go kill some shit.
I suppose everything.
more experienced at fighting than we are. How should we do this?
You just wait here. I'll do it all.
You must be very confident in your skills. It's your decision. We'll wait until you've killed most of them.
Hey, can I have your ear for a second?
Some kind of problem, Gage?
No, boss. Not at all. I just wanted to say that this, you know, the two of us working together like this, well, it's been a damn good time. I left Nuka World with you, hoping you'd be the overboss the gangs needed. Seems like I didn't need to worry in the least. No question you know how to take care of yourself, which is more than I can say for most. But damn, if you don't have fun doing it, and more than that, I know you got my back. I can trust you. I can't say that about anybody else.
What? You worried I'm gonna turn on you?
No, boss. Not anymore. But most raiders, you can't trust them. You know, I made some bad calls when I was younger. I ain't saying I regret the choices I made, just that early on, I was a little starry-eyed. First gang took me in when I was 16. Decent-sized group, fair amount of muscle, only they weren't using it as best they could. Me being new and young, I didn't know enough to keep my mouth shut. Started making suggestions about how to improve things.
So, what happened?
Well, eventually the boss approaches me. Connor, his name was. I don't remember what stupid-ass name he used back then. The Harvester or something. It was never as intimidating as he thought it was. Laughable, almost. Anyway, at first I think he's pissed, like I'm undermining his authority. But he actually listens to me. He takes my advice.
And where is this guy now?
Now hang on. Don't get ahead of me. So here I am. This teenage punk who's got the ear of what seems like the most powerful guy around. I'm on top of the damn world. Connor's always coming to me, asking what I think of his plans, telling me how much he trusts me. Can't lie. It all went to my head. After something like a year of working closely together goes by, we come up with this plan to make peace with a rival gang. We work the whole thing out in secret, where we meet on neutral ground, who does the negotiating, and what happens if shit goes south. I was more than happy to take point on negotiating with three of our biggest guys to back me up in case no one took me seriously.
Did it work? Did they listen to you?
Not at first, but they came around. About an hour in, they're just starting to come around and realize the deal is in their best interest. And then I hear it. Gunfire and explosions. Lots of both. At first I'm thinking, oh shit, something went wrong. Connor's gonna have to bail us out. But the more time that goes by, the more I start to realize what's happening. The fucker set me up, and I fell for it. See, he figured he's pumped me for all the information I was good for. Have me around for much longer, I'd be a threat to his position. So he used us as a diversion, something to keep the other gang's attention while he and his men ambush them. He gets their stuff, and I just happen to die in the crossfire. Perfect day for him.
How'd you make it out of that alive?
I'll be honest, I couldn't tell you. You know how folks say it was all a blur? Well, it really was. I find myself on the other side of this whole thing. Messed up, but alive. I can't go back. The one guy I thought I could trust tried to get me killed. Thought about going in shooting, but that was just anger, revenge talking. And I knew where that would end up. So I moved on. Promised myself I was never gonna be that stupid again. Was never gonna trust anyone to do anything but look out for themselves.
Great story, Gage. But where are you going with this?
Ever since that day, I ain't trusted nobody. At least not beyond how useful they can be to me. You, though, You're the real deal. I finally found somebody worth fighting with. Something worth fighting for. I don't mean to make it weird or nothing. I'm just saying, this is a real good thing we've got going here.
Never thought I'd say this to a raider, but you're damn good company. I'm lucky to have you supporting me.
That means a lot, boss. Really does. Well, I figure this is enough sharing or whatever, yeah? We probably ought to get back to it. But really, thanks. I mean it.
Identified intruder detected. Beginning search. This area clear. Proceeding with search protocol.
You